Hi, this is John. Welcome back. And tonight I'm going to make tortilla soup. Now, tortilla soup is great. It's a little bit spicy, nice chicken broth with chicken pieces inside, tomatoes, and it's a really fantastic and easy thing to make. So let's take a look at what the ingredient list is. So the ingredient list for tortilla soup is actually pretty simple. It can be pretty complex, but this one, of course, is simple. So this is what we've got. Chicken breast, that's with the skin on and bone in. Chicken broth, onion, garlic, jalapeno, cilantro, and vegetable oil. I'm also going to add some tomato. Also, for tortilla soup, there's a couple of garnishes you can add, which are really great. If you can find at your grocery store corn tortillas, just flat corn tortillas, you can cut those into strips and you can either bake them in the oven at 425 for a few minutes until they're nice and crispy, or sometimes you can just do it in a little bit of vegetable oil on the stovetop, and that makes a nice crunchy garnish. I'm just going to use tortilla chips because my grocery store sucks and I can't get corn tortillas anymore, so I'll have to use good old-fashioned nachos. It just adds a little bit of crisp, which is nice. Other garnishes are sour cream and Monterey Jack cheese. You can also add a little more cilantro, a little more tomato. It's really up to you. Okay, so I've got my stock pot here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to add 8 cups of chicken broth. I'm going to add in 2 onion quarters cut from my onion. I'm going to add in 2 cloves of garlic, just peeled, crushed slightly if you want. I'm going to add in about 10 sprigs of cilantro. I'm also going to add in about 1/2 teaspoon of salt. The last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add in my chicken breast. I'm going to turn this on a medium-high heat and let it come to a boil. So while I wait for the chicken broth to boil, I'm going to do the next part, which is mixing together some of the other ingredients. I've got 2 diced tomatoes. I put them in the food processor. To that, I'm going to add my 2 other halves of my onion. A couple cloves of garlic. I'm putting 3 in, 2 or 3, doesn't matter to me. Half my jalapeno. You can leave the seeds in. The seeds and the ribs actually add the heat. So if you want a little less heat, you can take those out and just put in the outside of the jalapeno. I'm going to add all in, of course. This is my chipotle pepper, which is in there with some of the sauce. You can find chipotles probably in your Tex-Mex aisle if you have one. That's usually where they keep it, well, at least in my grocery store, but who knows, we're a little messed up over here. Put that in there. Blitz for about 20 seconds. Beautiful, that's perfect. So I'm gonna set that aside for a few minutes. What I'm going to do is, once it does hit a boil, I'm going to turn it down to low, and I'm going to cover it and poach the chicken for about 20 minutes. Okay, my chicken's still cooking, so what I've done is I've added a tablespoon of vegetable oil over high heat in another stock pot. Once it starts to shimmer, I'm going to add that tomato mixture that we mixed down in here and basically cook it for about 10 minutes. Okay, we've got some good shimmer action happening here. So I'm going to add this mixture back into my cup. I'm going to add just a little bit of salt, like maybe 1/8 of a teaspoon. And what I want to do is just cook this for about 10 minutes. Okay, my chicken should be nicely poached. So I'm going to take that out of the stock and just put it aside. And let the chicken cool down a bit. Okay, you can see our tomato mixture here is reduced down quite a bit. Changed color, a little bit darker, that's nice. It's been about 10 minutes. So what we want to do is we want to take our stock that we basically just created from our chicken and strain it and add it in. Woo! So the soup is just starting to come to a boil. What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn it down to low. And I'm gonna let it simmer for about 15 more minutes. Just let all the flavors meld together. Take a chicken and shred the chicken up, add that in with some of our garnishes, and then you can pop your favorite cerveza and enjoy your very spicy tortilla soup. I'll be back in 15 minutes. Okay, so it's been about 15 minutes. My soup has been simmering for a while. I'm gonna add my shredded chicken, put the shred off the breast, and I'm just gonna let that simmer for about another 5 minutes. And then we're pretty much done. Okay, so the soup's all done simmering, so we're just gonna finish it off here. Basically, we do is take a bowl. I'm using a small bowl here on purpose, just to show you how to finish it off. You can take your tortilla chip or your corn tortilla if you've done that, and your soup in over top. And that's it. You basically garnish it with, like I said, some cheese, Monterey Jack. You put a little sour cream in if you want. You can add some cilantro if you chop some cilantro, avocado, a little bit of lime if you want. And then all you need to do is eat. Enjoy tortilla soup. And of course, I forgot the most famous garnish of all, cerveza. Enjoy.